Welcome to the Cockney Watchdog cast, episode 3, the long overdue Cockney Watchdog cultural, what's the word, reappropriation.
That's not.
AKA Two Dogs and the Truth tonight. The little known EP from 2000, Mother's Day Birthday. No cover art. It's just bundled right in there on the as a bonus on top of King's Royal CD that we covered last time. The lineup is simply King's Az, King Brendan, and Dr. Sample.
We're all
done and dusted in 9 Earth minutes. Only
nice.
Only 4 tracks. The first one of which is this one. So
nice. No, that's us. Castle,
then Flounder will splash around to get his attention, and then
down
we'll go.
Down here is your home. Ariel, listen to me. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more are you looking for? Under the sea.
Here is the actual Cockney Watchdogs version.
Land ain't happy, the fish on the land ain't happy. The fish on the land ain't happy. This is nowhere for a fish to spend the day. No way at all. Up on the land they are working. A big head, it's no way to spend the day. On the earth, you're better. I'm down here, observe, it's worse. And my girlfriend is a trout. But it's okay, cause she likes me. We need to run this song turn. Some special message. I am moron.
Megan, Megan.
Now, say what you will about the Cockney Watchdogs, but we've come on a long way from the Mr. Men based tune, and now we're dealing with Little Mermaid samples and bongos and Zaz screaming with a theme. Yeah. What was going on in this song, Zaz?
I have no recollection. I don't remember this at all. I remember the Little Mermaid.
The Disney movie.
Yes. What do I say at the end?
My favourite line is, and my girlfriend's a trout, but that's okay because I like her, or something like that. But then he's shouting, I am Mordon! I am Mordon! I'm guessing it's some kind of cartoon reference.
Possibly. I thought I was saying Mole Man.
There is an album by the Lovely Eggs called I Am Moron, but that is a recent.
I don't think I'm saying the word moron.
Really?
I think I'm saying like Mormon or like Merman, like it's someone's name.
I would suggest that, here we go, Freakazoid, season 2 credits, the summer of 2000, I Am Moron.
The aliens may bring to us the wisdom of the universe. If not, we'll blast them.
I am Moron. I come with a important message.
Mystery solved. So Zaz, definitely Cartoon Network was heavily on your rotation in this era. You'd have been 10 years old. And not only that, from the bushes, Bill Clinton.
Bill Clinton and Gort, the alien Gort.
That's Hillary Clinton.
Still.
Yeah, probably. Anyway,
the other one looks like Stump, to be honest.
A little bit. But isn't that brilliant? So I actually think your version, our version, is much better than the original Little Mermaid. I'm a mermaid like Tom Hanks, and that's a good line to take it to the bridge, which is from the Robbie Williams song Strong.
Nice. I don't remember him singing about Tom Hanks.
Early morning when I wake up, I look like Kiss but without the makeup, and that's a good line to take it to the bridge. Very good. Lazy. Very good indeed. We get themed like Moby Dick. Is that one of the lines? The scurry face of the Simpsons will not scare us down here. Classic Cockney Watchdogs stuff.
Very anchored in the year 2000.
Only 90s kids will understand this song.
Exactly. BuzzFeed. I say something like, down here it's better, down there, up here, down there it's worse.
So the second track is called Up and Down. And it's a concept song about feeling low and then feeling happy with some great growling backing vocals from Zaz. So let's have a listen to Up and Down. Once again, it has some horrific tones going on that makes it very hard to listen to.
The character was an evil character that was frowned.
Some nice layered sampling there from Dr. Sample, which was very nice. What's your take on that concept song?
It's okay. It's not as bad as some of the things that come later. I initially thought this might be the worst song we have, and I remembered some of the ones that come on later.
There's many, many more to go, but there's a few samples going on, some of which I don't remember. One of them is from a Gorky Zygotic Monkey song, Merched in Noid Gewalt Oi Gied. Welsh as they were. Have a listen to this.
Zygotic monkey, ich num, it's talking us at sea, or Gorgi's zygotic monkey, ich num.
Cause we ain't got school in the morning, baby. No, 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 no. Ain't got school in the morning, baby. No, 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 no. Ain't got school in the morning.
The greatest Welsh band of all time, Gorky's Zygotic Monkey. We ain't got
good.
School in the morning, and we stole that for this song.
That sounds good, about right.
Good sentiment, right? The real anti-school song comes later.
Oh, yes. I led the last one and you led this one, so it's like a good solo each.
I think so. It's almost like we had released like a cool 7-inch single with you on one side and me on the other, and then there's a nice third track coming up and a completely pointless spoken word fourth track.
Yeah.
But there's also a beautiful sample buried in this song of So Long Frank Lloyd Wright. You also shout I am moron several times in this song as well. But here we go. So Long Frank Lloyd Wright.
I never left so long. So long, so long. Architects make a man, architects make a when. Never change your point of view. When I run dry, I'd stop a while and think of you.
Beautiful. We stole some of that and made it even better in our song. So Long Frank Lloyd Wright. It's not a very well-known Simon and Garfunkel tune, but it is a stormer, a banger, if you will.
It is good. Is that the one about the boxer?
It is. Sonny Liston.
Yeah, exactly. America. we got out of a phase of sampling things for a while, didn't we? Between like maybe CW5 to 6, but now we're back in business.
I think the samples were thick and fast on this one. Appeared a little bit on some of the tracks before. This one's all samples. I actually think the next few don't have a lot of samples on. I think then we get into, once we got into the new era, if you like, samples became the go-to.
Yes.
So that takes us to the third song, which is a cover of My My Hey Hey Out of the Blue by Neil Young. Our version is so lodged in my head now that I cannot even imagine that if I hear the original without you singing over the top of it, it just doesn't work. I'm not going to spoil the original. I'm going to play it first and then we'll play our version. Still big, I'll get an electric guitar. So sampling the Live Rush version with a nice ring modulator on your vocals and the greatest line of all time, which is...
Rock 7 Roll is here to stay.
Let's have a listen to what you did with Neil Young's My My Hey Hey Dr. Sample on the samples.
Get caught up. Reading.
My My Hey Hey.
Sing.
You.
I'm singing with you.
Go on then.
Two.
Beautiful, and it's definitely better than the original. And here's why I couldn't find it, because it's on Live Rust. It's not on Rust Never Sleeps. Rust.
I see. How many times did he put this song on albums?
Well, the original one was Rust Never Sleeps was the album, but Live Rust was the live version of that album. Here we go. So somehow we found a sample that's not on the original. Brilliant. What do you make of that song, Sass?
Beautiful, rarer than ever. Somehow one of our more normal entrances. It's very straightforward when you think about it. It's just a cover.
It is just a cover where we sample the original and sing over the original and make it better. No bongos, though.
Just a cover. I prefer what we did with the lyrics than what Kurt Cobain did with the lyrics.
Exactly. Very good.
Probably the only, probably our darkest Cockney Watchdogs song, connection-wise.
I guess so, but we do a cover version of Someone Saved My Life Tonight by Elton John.
Oh, yeah.
Later. But maybe that's a song of hope, whereas this is something that we disagree that it's better to burn out than to fade away. It's better to
set a light
in a bin. Here's the bonus track, though. Nathan's Christmas talk.
No, those are my presents. Okay, this one was not me. You break them off, I believe. You break them off, have you? What have you done? What reading, ladies and gentlemen, what? When they said they'll break.
So there you go, just a little gem of Nathan being threatened by some woman about presents.
Who was that? Who were those people?
The people in the background were me and a couple of people from my rock and roll band. We were in the Scout Hut in Plattbridge, and you were visiting. It must have obviously been Christmas time, probably about, this is much earlier than this EP, which again makes it strange that it appeared on here. But the lady who from the Scout Hut did not want you to touch her presents.
Touch them and I'll hit you.
She actually said if you break them, she'll hit you. And she could have actually been talking to me, who stood next to you, and may have well been shaking the present boxes.
That's true. These are my presents.
So that's Mother's Day birthday. Our mother's birthday is on Mother's Day some
that's
years.
That's not true.
Because her birthday is May the 13th, which occasionally, once every several years, falls on a Sunday, which is also Mother's Day. And obviously in the year 2000, that's exactly what happened.
It is. And this was, I'm assuming, the offering you had to save money.
I don't think we gave this to Mother. I think it was just a celebration of the... of the beautiful synchronicity that Mother's Day was also birthday. As you'll see, none of the songs relate even slightly to mothers or celebrations of anywhere. One was a Little Mermaid rip, one was a Gorky's rip, and one was a straight up cover of a Neil Young song.
Which I don't think our mother would have any interest in hearing.
She would not like any of those.
5-year-old son covering Neil Young.
Well, to be honest, you would have been 10 at this point.
Yeah, that's true.
But we had a bit of an argument, classic Cockney Watchdogs argument to start with a song. And all in all, even though there's only a few tracks, it's a sweet listen.
It is. It's a good, it's compact. It is the opposite of how you would describe CW's 2 and 3.
So essentially, it rounds up the first little bit of the King's pre-Cockney Watchdog years. So we had the O'Leary's album, then King Brendan and King Nathan's Royal CD, and then the Mother's Day birthday EP that took us into the new century. And next up on episode 4, we'll be coming to CW1. A gem, a pure gem.
This is essentially the Cockney Watchdogs Avengers assemble, and we are going to be moving very soon into our Age of Ultron.
Very good. All right, well, bye.
See ya.
That was a fun one.